All right, you know what time it is. It's time for motherfucking vlog, my niggas. And I gotta get my seat back for this one. Gotta get comfortable. April 1st, Controversy 4 is gonna be in stores on all streaming platforms. Make sure you cop that. If you like the album, make sure you go to GrizzyHendrix.com and support that. Let's get into this album review on Joyner Lucas' album. So, today I was up early, you know, doing what I gotta do. And I listened to the album straight through, listened to Joyner Lucas' album. And how do I motherfucking feel about it? I hate to say it, guys. For all you Joyner Lucas fans, I hated this album. I hate it. I hate it. I hate it. I hate it. I hate this album. This album is horrible to me. All right, I'm not going to say horrible because there are songs that I actually like on this album. You know what I'm saying? And I figured out what it is. I'm going to say exactly what it is. So, as a album, I hate this album. But as him, you know, just if he was just dropping singles for us, there's a lot of singles that I actually love on this. You know what I'm saying? I like the I Will song, even though I think that song is so easy to make. Like, a song like that is, oh my gosh. There's, like, for an artist, it really doesn't take a lot to, you know, reference a movie from Will Smith and then throw it in a whole song and then, you know, just make it make sense. It's not really that creative for Joyner Lucas, because Joyner Lucas is a talent. All right, he is a talent, so that shit is easy for him. But is it a dope song? I still like the song. Was the video amazing? The video was amazing. But back to this motherfucking album. Yeah, as a whole collective project, the album just sucks to me. This album is like if Future decided to go lyrical and Future decided to put, you know, be a lyricist. This is the album I feel like I'd get. Like, this album just sounds like Joyner is trying too hard to like cross over into that mainstream world and not just be a dope internet rapper. It sounds like he's really, you know, he's just trying to be on the radio, man. There's a lot of songs that just don't mesh well in this album. And I know people are going to say, well, the theme of it is ADHD and this and that, so it's like different. No, my nigga, no. Because even when you're doing an album that has a theme and it's an ADHD theme, it still has to be cohesive as a whole body of work. It has to come together. It has to make sense. Like, there's so many ways that I feel he could have approached this topic if you're going to call your album ADHD. Like, somebody like Kendrick, I feel, would have executed the theme of this project amazingly. Even somebody like, I feel like J. Cole would have. But as far as Joyner goes, Joyner's just all over the place on this album. Like, and it's not a good all over the place, because when you make albums, you could give different vibes and you know, you might want to do a trap vibe here. You might want to do a, all right, I'm going to hit you with a hip-hop vibe here. I'm going to hit you with a eclectic vibe here. No, it has to come together. This just didn't feel like it came together. Whether skits, you know, holding shit together, yeah. But the actual album is just it's a snoozer. I'll never go back to this motherfucking album ever. And I know when I like an album, because after I like an album, it's in my Apple Music library. I automatically, boop, this is going right into the Apple Music library, because I know I'm going to be listening to this. Like, just now, I was listening to Party Next Door album. Boop, hit that button quick, fast, because I could already feel the vibe, and the vibe is captivating me. Joyner Lucas's album did not captivate me at all. I left with nothing from this album. Not a sense of a understanding of the ADHD theme. I didn't understand shit other than, okay, there's a few good songs on this shit. But overall, you know, Joyner Lucas gets Super Saiyan Goku slaps from me for making this album. I feel like he should have scrapped this album and just gave niggas singles, because this shit does not compare to his first album. And anybody out there who says that, nigga, don't even front. This album is nowhere near his first album. It's not even on, like, a smidget level of his first album. So knock that shit off. And for the people who's sensitive about this, you're hating on Joyner. I want Joyner to win. I actually love Joyner. I think Joyner is an amazing talent. But was this album up to par? No. Was this album even worth me going back to? No. You know what I got for that? I got some farts for that. Because that's what this album was, a big fart.
GrizzyHendrix.com.